The Sound of Frogs, written by Breinholdt. I have always found the sound that frogs make creepy, in the same way that you find the sound of the wind creepy when you're home alone. I don't know why, but I think it's because I always thought it sounds like someone crying, or at least they do where I live. I live in an apartment in an area known as Bird's Vault. I found this name funny because there really aren't that many birds in the area. We moved there when I was around 12 years old. My mom and dad had gotten a divorce, and he had bought her out of the house. I was excited when we moved in because the apartment complex was surrounded by a small park with a playground, and a small forest with a small swamp, like a lake, and in this lake lived frogs. I used to play with and without my friends all day on the playground, and I was trying to build a treehouse in a big tree at the edge of the lake. We thought that a treehouse would be a perfect secret place to have fun, even though everyone would be able to see it if we actually built it. When I turned 14, our neighbor's baby disappeared. She was only 4 months old. The mom had left her in the backyard in their baby carriage for a couple of minutes, and when she returned, the baby was gone. They called the police and searched for the missing child, but they couldn't find anything. Everybody was shocked, and people got afraid of leaving their child alone for too long. But, like everything else, people slowly started to forget about it, and things slowly went back to normal again. 4 months after this first disappearance, another child went missing. This time it was a 9-year-old boy named James. He was the younger brother of my friend. The night that James went missing, I slept with my window opened because it was raining, and I loved the sound of it. But I heard something weird. It sounded like someone was crying. I thought that it might be James, so I ran downstairs and put on my shoes before running outside in the pouring rain. The noise was coming from the playground. I thought that James must have gotten lost and had found his way to the playground when it started to rain. So he had probably taken shelter in the playhouse. I ran to the playhouse and opened the door only to find it empty, and then I realized that it wasn't crying that I was hearing. It was the frogs. The frogs' croaking sounded almost exactly like crying. I laughed at myself. I had run outside in the middle of the night because of some stupid frogs. Except it wasn't the frogs. 2 days after that night, some kids went to take a swim in the lake. A kid named Mick, who was around my age, had dived down to look for some treasure, and he brought up a plastic bag filled with something. He brought it up with him, and when they opened it up, they found it filled with rocks and the corpse of a baby. The baby that had gone missing. They went and told their parents about it, and then they called the police. The police searched the lake and found another plastic bag with James inside it. They found some skin under his nails that had probably gotten there when he had tried to escape his killer. It turned out to be a lady that lived in a house not so far from Bird's Vault. Her own children had gotten suffocated, and her husband had left her because he thought that she had done it. But he didn't have any evidence. Apparently, she had gotten the taste of killing, and she had decided to use our apartment complex as her target. I've never told anyone about that night that James drowned in the lake, because I blame myself for what happened to him. I might could have saved him if I had just realized that it wasn't the bloody frogs making that horrible sound. I can't even hear the sound of frogs croaking anymore without thinking about it. I can't even look my friends in the eyes anymore. All because of the sound of frogs. Couch Surfing, written by Breinholdt. I've been on a lot of vacations where I've been couch surfing. I've had a lot of good experiences, but also a few bad. And this time, I don't know what to call it, but I think I'll take a break from doing vacations this way, at least for a while. I had just hitchhiked in Arizona to see some places that were supposed to be haunted. Because I'm that kind of guy. I had planned to sleep in the house of a family of three, a mom, a dad, and their six-year-old daughter. I had made contact with them through a website that's used to find people willing to let you borrow their couch in exchange for a small sum of cash. The dad, a man in his early 30s, had picked me up in his car and we had driven to his house. Once we got there, he showed me around and then introduced me to the family and we proceeded to eat dinner. But they wanted to thank God first. This is mostly completely normal for a religious family in the USA, but something was off. "Thank you, Lord, for bringing us this wonderful meal. Thank you for showing us the way of the dark. Thank you for your sacrifice," they chanted while looking directly at me. I didn't really ask into it because I didn't want to be rude and maybe insult their religion. The rest of the night was ordinary. We talked a little about life and they asked why I decided to travel by hitchhiking and couch surfing. I told them the usual, that I wanted to meet new people, and after that I went to bed. The next day we went to visit a national park, where it's said that there are supposedly skinwalkers, a Native American legend about shamans that use dark magic to turn themselves into shapeshifters. I spent most of my day hiking, exploring the caves and caverns, and talking to other guests who were there. At some point we went back to the house and dined again, but this time they didn't pray, and again I didn't ask. Night came around and I decided to go to bed early because I was going to continue my trip across the US the next day. So I said goodnight and went to bed. But I couldn't fall asleep because of this weird feeling of something being off. I laid there on the couch for hours and tried to sleep, but I just couldn't. At some point I looked outside and I froze. There was someone standing just at the edge of the garden. Just barely visible. I was about to get up and go get the dad when I heard the door to the living room open. Then I heard muffled footsteps entering the room and stopping just behind the couch. I didn't react. Instead, I acted as if I were asleep. I heard a low whispering of words that I didn't understand. And after 10 or 15 minutes, I heard the door open again. And the footsteps leaving the room again. I opened my eyes and looked outside and I saw that the figure in the garden was gone. I got up and I grabbed my stuff after getting some warm clothes on and left the house in a hurry. After a few hours of walking, I was picked up by a passing car. I don't know what would have happened if I had stayed, but I'm glad that I didn't find out.